Hey curl friends, you've come to the right place. Welcome back to the Swirly Curly channel. In today's video, we are gonna talk about four reasons why your natural hair is lacking moisture and what to do about it. Moisture is a really, really big culprit of a lot of people's dry hair. They don't know how to moisturize. They don't know what products to pick to help their hair lock in moisture, and they often have no idea about the concept of moisture when it comes to their hair and how that really determines how healthy your hair is, how it looks, and how the results you're gonna get at the end of your wash day routine. So I'm here to walk you through all of that today. Before I begin, just wanna let you know I'm Keziah. I'm the creator and founder of Swirly Curly, and Swirly Curly is a company I created about 6 years ago from my studio apartment in Hollywood, California, when I had one idea for making a hair tie to fit around natural hair. And since then, I've created a whole bundle of different products that really cater to making natural hair easy for the community. So if you're interested in finding more about Swirly Curly and about the company and looking into our products, you can visit us at swirlycurlyhair.com. I'm also gonna put the link down below in the caption box so you can visit us there and check out all of our products that we have. Now, if you're ready, let's get right into this video. All right, you guys, so there is four reasons why your hair is lacking moisture. I'm gonna go through all the reasons, so you wanna stay till the very end of this video because each one of these is very important. It's something that you're gonna wanna do pretty much on a weekly or a daily basis to really combat dry hair and give your hair more moisture and more love that it really does deserve. So reason number one, you are probably wrapping your hair or sleeping on fabrics that are cotton-based and not using satins or silks on your hair. Now this is a really big thing because a lot of people heard the term or they know of people wrapping their hair, but if they don't actually do it themselves, they're missing out on so much. And this is like the number one culprit right here, is that if you're sleeping or wrapping your hair with cottony fabrics, rayons, and things like that that are not satin and silks, your hair is getting stripped of any moisture that it has. So cotton fabrics often are known to basically take out and soak up moisture and things like that. So that is why we use like cotton towels and things like that, because when you wipe somewhere that has water, it's really absorbent. Now, if you were to have like a slip dress, for instance, you know, if you're wearing one of those out and you're sweaty and everything, and you're like, oh my God, you can just tell that the sweat is just staying on you. And if you were to take that and you were trying to wipe up some water, like for an example, if you go to a restaurant and they give you those fabric napkins and you try to wipe up any water on the table, it doesn't wipe up right. And that's because that is more on the side of like a satin and silk type of fabric. So it's not going to dry up moisture. It's actually going to keep it and hold it in to wherever that's at or wherever it's covered. So think about that. If you're sleeping on cottons and other fabrics, you're gonna want to change. Now you wanna invest in some really good products for yourself. I have two here. There's two options that you can do. You can do a head scarf for your head. A lot of people like to do pineapples and things like that. Or you can do a satin bonnet. Both of these are sold on swirlycurlyhair.com on my website. They're thoroughly breaded, thoroughly checked by me to make sure that these are highest qualities of satin and silks that we can get that are affordable and that are gonna work great for your hair. Now I'm gonna demonstrate how you would put a bonnet on your hair. So you would just put it over your head when it's time to go to sleep. And for this bonnet, you can snap it on so you can adjust whatever size fits best for you or what feels most comfortable. And then you were to go to sleep. And the morning you then take it off. You also wanna make sure that your edges are protected with your bonnet. So if your bonnet is not satin underneath all the way to the edges, you're gonna wanna look and get a different one, because come on, your edges are just as important as the ends of your hair. So make sure you're looking into all of that and really, really doing your research on the products that you're buying for yourself. The second one is a headscarf. So I'll show you how I would pineapple my hair and then cover the pineapple so that your hair isn't exposed to cotton. and that you're sleeping on, again, all of the satin, all of the silk fabrics, so that your hair is completely protected. So these are two ways that you can protect your hair, but overall, you wanna make sure satin and silk is what you're wrapping your hair with. This is going to keep the moisture that you add into your hair in your hair. It's not going to escape faster, and your hair is going to feel more moisturized and softer longer. The reason number two that your hair is lacking moisture is you never put moisture in to begin with. I know. So I was a newbie when it came to this. I didn't realize that my hair continuously was dry and dry and dry because I never actually put any moisture into my hair. Now, how can you put moisture into your hair? There's a couple of different ways that you can do this, and I talk about this in a lot of my videos, is steaming. Steaming your hair and allowing steam to really penetrate through the cuticles is really gonna help your hair so much. So when you're steaming, it's opening up your hair so that basically your hair strands are like this, and then the follicles are gonna be able to open up so that moisture and water can get through to the root of your hair and really hydrating it, because our hair needs to be hydrated just like everything else on our body needs to be hydrated. So this is a big thing. I actually did a video, you can find it out right here, on how you can steam at home and the various different ways you can do that. I do wanna say, once you put steaming in your regimen, it's going to do so many wonders for you. I actually don't have to steam as frequent or as often as I did in the beginning, because my hair has stayed consistently moisturized with me just doing my wash day and putting, you know, my deep conditioner in my hair and letting the water get to my hair. That has been amazing for me, but it's taken me about 3 years to get to that place. So just thinking about, my hair has been so dry for so long, it took a long time to really get it hydrated. But hopefully that is not the case for you. Hopefully you'll get there a lot sooner if you start right now and putting steam into your regimen. So far, I've already talked about two reasons on why your hair is lacking moisture. Now, before I go on to the next two, I just wanna let you know, if these are sounding amazing to you and sounding great and you're like, absolutely, you're so right, I know what you're talking about, and you would want this information to go to another friend for her to understand how to really master their natural hair, I'm gonna ask you right now to give this video a big thumbs up and comment below and let me know, like, thank you, Keziah, this has been awesome, or let me know what you've learned so far, because the way that YouTube works is the more action we get on this video, the more it's gonna share it with other curlies in the community. So I really want this information to go to those who are in need, and the way that you can help is by giving it a big thumbs up, commenting below, and also subscribing to this channel, because I bring out videos to you twice a week, Mondays and Thursdays, and full of education all about natural hair. So I wanna make sure that you're taken care of there. And last but not least, if you want further help with your natural hair, come visit me at curlcollege.com. Curl College is an educational platform that I created a few years ago for women who are really struggling with their natural hair. I guide you through tutorial-based videos on how to take care of your natural hair, whether that is getting moisture to your hair, whether that's your nighttime routine and really mastering that, or how to pretty much bring your curls back to life every day of the week. Check me out, curlcollege.com. I'm giving away a 14-day free trial for anyone who wants to sign up. I'm gonna put the link down below for you as well. And last but not least is that we do a Q&A and a one-on-one talking where I can help you further with your hair. So if you wanna join the Facebook group and you wanna get more help with your hair, do the 14-day trial, come find me on the Facebook group and let's talk about your hair. All right, so now I wanna get into the reason number three on why your hair is lacking moisture, is most likely you have product buildup. Now, product buildup is a really big issue. A lot of people don't even know that they have this. And I find it happens a lot in type 4 hair, because I am a type 4 hair girl. I have a little bit of each, A, B, and C. And with our hair, because it is naturally drier than other textures, especially when it comes to just the fill, we tend to add more product to our hair. And we've also been taught to add more product. So we're the ones adding the shea butters, the oils, the mango butters, just like lathering on so much product as much as possible. We often co-wash our hair, and we often will wash our hair every other week or something like that, because we think that by adding water and washing our hair, it's gonna really strip out the moisture that we've added. But that's actually false. Very, very false. So product buildup comes from not washing your hair enough, using really heavy oils and shea butters on your hair, and also using products that are really high in silicones and things like that. So what you're gonna wanna do is you're going to want to remove all of that and cleanse your hair, and you're gonna wanna add lightweight products onto your hair. So meaning cutting out products that are heavy in oils and shea butters and going for something that's full of water, it has other creams and things like that to give your hair a break so that it can actually soak in the moisture. So another example is if we were gonna go in and try to steam our hair when we have all kinds of product on it, it's not going to take in the steam at all. You gotta take off all that product and then steam your hair. So check out the steaming course. Start working on getting that product buildup out of your hair, and I'll do another video exactly on product buildup and how to just really get it gone so that I can help you further with your hair. Okay, so the fourth and final reason on why your hair is most likely lacking in moisture is the fact that you do not drink enough water yourself. I know, this one is kind of shocking. And you wouldn't think that this would have anything to do with the hair on your head, but it has everything to do with the hair on your head, because it is attached to your body and we are live living beings. So the food that we consume, the water we consume, all of that is going to be used to grow our hair, our skin, and our nails. And in general, most people do not drink enough water. They are often walking around dehydrated. And here is a way you can find out if you're one of those people that walk around dehydrated 24/7. So the minimum amount of water one wants to drink is done by a simple equation. So I'm gonna put this simple calculation right here. So it's your body weight multiplied by 2/3, or 0.67. Now you're gonna do that, you times it. For me, I get 2.5 liters. 2.66 is actually what it says. Now I need to drink 2.5 of these big old liter bottles that I carry around, and I do. On a daily basis, I drink 3 of these because I know my minimum is 2.5 when I'm not exercising, but I often exercise at least 5 times a week. So my goal is to drink 3 of these every day. Now, are you drinking that much water? And just to let you know, my body weight, I'm 135, between 135 and 140, and this is pounds. And you know, it's a struggle to get that much in on a daily basis. I have to really be conscious of it. So I am going to suggest to you right now to take this on for a week and be really conscious of how much water you're intaking. Watch every cup you're sipping. I mean, get a bottle and see how much you're drinking, because this is gonna change the game for your hair. If your body does not have enough water to produce its normal functions with digesting, you know, eliminating and things like that, like how do you think your body is going to then give it to your hair to be moisturized? It does matter. It really, really, really does matter. So check yourself, see how much water you're drinking, and increase it. And the more you increase it, see how your hair responds to it. Trust me, it's going to be really, really interesting. You're gonna be like, okay, yeah, my hair does feel a lot better, along with the other 3 reasons why your hair could be lacking moisture. Now, those are the 4 reasons. I hope that this video really, really helps you. I hope that it brings a lot to your attention. Let me know if any of these reasons down below in the comments that you might be lacking, that you're going to start working into your everyday life. I really hope that this helps. Once again, subscribe to this channel, hit the notification button so that you can be notified whenever my videos come out. Again, I release videos 2 times a week, Monday and Thursdays, and it's all about education on your natural hair and really how to master your natural hair. If you want further help with your hair, once again, join me at Curl College. It's curlcollege.com. I will see you there, ask me the questions that you need, and we'll talk on the live call. Thank you all. Have a great day. Bye-bye.